So some user interactions need 60 frames a second, but so do transitions and animations like card expansions or a menu sliding in. Those need to be at 60 frames a second too, which isn't always simple. It's so easy to accidentally trigger performance issues unless you're very careful about which properties you animate and when. There are many ways to tackle animations, and it completely depends on your project. I'll give you an example of one approach I've used. I feel like I'm kind of getting into one weird trick territory here, but seriously, this one actually works. For the 2014 Chrome Dev Summit website, I wanted to animate these cards like so. I couldn't expand the cards fast enough to maintain 60 frames a second, so I had to try something a bit different. I tried working backwards. I call my strategy flip. First, last, invert, play. I took advantage of the fact that once the browser had done the initial hard work to run the animation once, I could run it backwards at very little cost. It's like pre-calculating the expensive work. My code took the start point of a card, and then it took the end point when the card was expanded. So let's say the card was about here when it started, and the icon was like that, and a title there. Using getBoundingClientRect, I measured all the elements' positions before and after. That then meant I knew how far everything needed to move on the page, and if its opacity had changed, I also knew that as well. So back here again. First, that's where the card starts. Last is where the card finished. Now we need to talk about inverting. I use the information from first and last to apply transform and opacity changes to reverse the animation. With a little bit of extra work with clipping, it was like the card had never moved. So now we've inverted the animation, we can just simply play it, and it looks like that.